Hello, everybody. Welcome to Cigar Review TV. I'm your host, Damon Pettit. And this time we are doing, get the the band the right way, 1592 Black Gold Toro. I have a feeling this baby might be have some strength to it. Let's do it. Although, I don't know. It says it's a Toro. It's got a bit of a kick in the pants right at the beginning. Feels a little box pressed. Like it's a little bit like that, see? Yeah, that's about it. I am going to, I know how, you know, a lot of people do the thirds, making the cigar, like, cut into thirds. I'm going to do mine in 17ths. So, looks like I'm working into my second 17th. And nice draw, a lot of smoke. Now I'm into my third 17th. Okay, I'm kidding. Obviously, that would be a bit much. But so far, really, you know, quite has a bit of a kick there. It has, it's Nicaraguan, it's a, got a double binder, and it's got a Maduro sun-grown wrapper. So more than likely, this is going to kick my ass. Very nice draw, though. Really strong. Strong bit of a black licorice. I really got that, like when I first put it in my mouth before I lit it. Really had that kind of a, I mean, it was almost very close to, sorry, I had a bug on there that I didn't want on there. Very close to, I don't know, just a much stronger than I was thinking right at first, but so far so good. I did not bring anything to drink, and that's going to be the first time, probably the first time I've ever smoked a cigar without something with it, except for maybe the very first time I smoked a cigar. And now there's been other times, I guess, that I've, but this will be my first review, I believe, without having something to drink with it, so. We'll see how that all goes. Those of you who watched my last review, I did it at an airport, and I did it on this Outlook deck. Outlook's the runway. There was like a big bomber there, a bomber jet, vintage. And I was there, and everything, great cigar, the whole thing. Fun to do. And then when it was over, I got all my stuff together and walked down, looked around, went to walk through the doors to go through the lobby and then outside. Locked. Everything was locked. Everybody was gone. I was like, okay, there's nobody here. There was nobody there. I mean, I was locked in. And I was starting to decide which fence I was going to have to find a way to jump over or crawl over. It was quite a large fence, and they had some, like, it was pretty well secure, not the kind of fence that people usually want to jump over or, you know, crawl over. And right as I was deciding which one it was going to be, security truck rolled up. I'm like, oh, hopefully, thank God. And luckily, they were cool, and they knew what, they could see that I meant no harm. And they were actually joking around, laughing, stuff like that. So it was pretty cool. It was pretty funny. I wasn't there that long, but I was really, really quite surprised that I got locked in there. It was fun, though. I mean, I always like those kind of things, and that was a good time. I didn't do a review last week, which you don't know that, unless you're always watching my stuff. But I just didn't really have the time, so I didn't do any. So I decided to go ahead and break this one out today. This is another cigar that's part of the House of Emilio. And look that up. So far, not bad. It's burning very nicely. It is definitely a nice, stronger cigar. For me, just because I'm a big coffee drinker, all that crap, I do definitely have that licorice feel, and then that black coffee feel as well. Very nice, though, so far. I'm liking it. Very enjoyable. Thank you very much, Gary. Appreciate that. I hope everybody's having a good week. Trying to think if there's been any... I really try not to watch the news. I don't think I really want to know what's going on anymore. But I guess there's been no like really incredible good news going on. Just regular shit. They had that massive, horrible mudslide, which is just awful. The plane that just disappeared. And then what else? The Final Four crap is over now. I'm not a big basketball guy. I will kind of, like, if those happen to be on, I'll watch those every now and then. If it's like playoffs or championship, it can be more interesting to me. I didn't watch any of them, of course, but I don't know who won. For you that are basketball fanatics, I'm sure you're like, what's wrong with you? It's just me. Let's see, what else? Football, yeah, they're having the Super Bowl is going to be here in Arizona next year. And, of course, they moved the Pro Bowl here next year as well. And Pro Bowl being probably the biggest bullshit professional exhibition game that there is. It's even more than it used to be, you know. I mean, it was always kind of, it was never the most popular thing in the world. But for me, with the way that they do the teams now, the uniforms are horrendous. Having the, you know, Jerry Rice and Deion Sanders be the, I don't know what the hell they even call them, but I don't know. It's honestly, to me, the biggest joke in professional sports. They really, in my opinion, should just get rid of the Pro Bowl. It's a joke. And to me, it's a slap in the face to the actual athletes that, you know, they used to, a long time ago, it used to be, you know, people that were involved in the game were the ones who picked the people in the Pro Bowl, and it meant a lot when you made the Pro Bowl. I mean, it was huge. You know, that was always one of the big statistics. You know, is 3-time Pro Bowler or whatever. It's like, wow, you know, you made the Pro Bowl. That's pretty cool. Not no more. Now it's that they'll still say that, but now it's just like, yeah, whatever. You know, it's because the other 5 people in front of them had other plans or were in the Super Bowl. I don't know. Anyway, that's all for a footballer. They did have some sort of anomaly in a picture on Mars. I have absolutely no doubt in my mind that there's, you know, you get visited from others. And, all that kind of crap, but that picture I'm not exactly sure, just because it is like a little light that's out there. It looks like a little light that's kind of shooting up or whatever. Could be a billion different things. Never know. So, but that's always interesting when you know. But the thing is with NASA and everything else, if you have ever done a lot of research into it, that they cover their shit up all the time. They, you know, they're not, I'm sure it's a lot harder now to cover up your photos, you know, Photoshop them and then put them out, that kind of thing. That's how it used to be done. They used to completely clean the photos before they released them. And so now with technology and people having their own stuff, people, you know, hacking into the different, those different video streams, those kind of things, it's going to be a little bit harder, so. Smoking good. This review is probably going to be a little bit shorter than my other ones have been lately, just because got a lot to do still. It's 9:00, so I've got a little bit more time tonight before I can relax. But I just wanted to definitely make sure I got a good little review in, smoke a nice cigar for the night, relax. Back at this little place here that's really nice and quiet. And at least usually is. I guess you never know how it's going to end up being. Someday it'll be a gang walk through here. You never know. The pool now it's nice outside. Let's do the weather, huh? One of my favorite things. Weather will be, come on, 76. 9:00 at night, not too bad. It's getting into the 90s now. It'll go back down a little bit, then I'll head back up. So, spring is here. Summer's on its way. So the pool, where I've done a few of the reviews at night or whatever, a little bit too noisy, a little bit too... many people. If I'm going to do it, a bunch of people and stuff like that, I'll go to one of the cigar stores and set up there, you know, and people can mill around and all that kind of thing. But you know, when it's usually there's family and stuff like that, I don't want to be blowing my smoke in their faces, even if it's kind of far away and it whiffs into them. I do know that people find cigar smoke the worst smell in the world, apparently. unless you smoke them or have been around them, I understand, I guess. So I try to be somewhat respectful to that, I guess. very nice, very, definitely a strong cigar. If you're looking for a nice, strong cigar, this one is not very thick. On the site it said that the Toro was like a 50 ring gauge, but I really don't think this is a 50. Pretty sure it's not. I mean, I've got medium-sized hands. I don't have these gigantic fucking man hands that some people have. But, you know, I don't want... You see? But the... So it's not that huge, so... It's kind of hard to tell. But... It's not, you know, I guess it looks big on there, but... compared to some of the... I don't know, maybe it's because, you know, we're getting these 80 ring gauge cigars, which, honestly, come on. Really? Do I really need to get that big? But there's no way I could smoke one of those comfortably and enjoy it. For me, I could. I'm not saying. Took me a few hits to knock that baby off of there, but it is smoking really nice. I'll put the retail, what it goes for retail there, because I did not look that up before I came over here, so I don't know what that is, but definitely going to recommend it if you like a strong cigar. I will not, however, I would not, if I was getting cigars for some people and they're, say there was somebody there and never smoked a cigar, only smoked a couple, probably wouldn't get this one for them. I might get, like, if there's another lighter one, which I believe that, you know, the 1592 does have, you know, I can't remember what they have, but it's a different one. And I'd probably go ahead and get one of those, I'm guessing, if it's anything like this, but just not as strong. This is a pretty strong and very nice, delicious. But I would not probably, you know, somebody who hasn't smoked a cigar for a while, probably wouldn't give it to them right away. Might give it to them to put in a humidor for a year down the road or 6 months when they've been smoking for a while. Always gotta think ahead, my friend. Easter's coming up next week, right? What is it, next week? What the fuck? Today's the 12th. No, it's not even next week. Good. I think it's like 2 weeks, something like that. Is it? That is the 20th. Maybe it is. Maybe it is next Sunday. I have no idea what day it is. I was thinking today was Sunday. Pretty sure it's, I think it is next week. I'm completely drawing a blank. I have no idea. I'm pretty sure it is. So, I don't know what, a lot of people, Easter's much, you know, very different. People are extremely, you know, one way or the other, they're definitely going to church. They're definitely doing the Easter egg hunt. They're definitely hanging at home and just, you know, sitting there drunk. I don't know. But everybody does different things on Easter, but I hope whatever it is you do, it's a safe one, an enjoyable one. And if it's with family, and if you have little ones that go hunting for the eggs, that was always fun. When I was a kid, I don't know why, I thought that was so cool. My parents would wake up, me and my sister would wake up in the morning, you know, walk out there, and we'd have Easter baskets, which when we go to bed, they were empty. And then, of course, we were really small, so this wasn't like a year ago, okay? You know, come out in the morning, they'd have the chocolate bunny and some jelly beans scattered in there, or whatever little toy that they'd give us. And then we get to hunt for the Easter eggs that we colored, because we would color the eggs day or two before, whatever that is. Then we'd hunt for all the eggs, and I'm sure my mom and dad were like, just find the eggs already. But so, that was fun for me. So I don't know, and so now my Easter really is nothing. I don't really do much. I used to go to church a lot, a long time ago. I don't go anymore. I'm not a religious guy anymore. I've got a spiritual thing going on, but no, I'm not affiliated with any kind of religion. So I don't think that there's any, you know, as long as the church is an accepting place and loves everybody that walks through those doors, it's a good thing. I ended up, I saw a NASCAR race right before I came out here. And Dale Earnhardt almost won that. Dale Earnhardt Jr. I know the other guys watching from above. You know, he's not my only one that I like, but I enjoy seeing him do well. So there's quite a few other drivers that I enjoy. But he did good. Wow. Very thick taste. Very thick. Get this. If you like a strong cigar, find that baby, okay? 1592. Black gold. I believe that's what it is, right? Yeah, black gold. All of a sudden, I did that one time. I smoked a cigar. I did a review. That was one of the only few reviews that I ended up not putting up because for some reason I was going to get ready to smoke this one cigar. They were both from the same place. This was when I was first doing them. And I picked the wine, I was doing it, and the whole time I was saying the wrong shit. And it was just, there was no way I was going to put that up. It was too ridiculous. I mean, even if I have to keep correcting myself, you know, and it'd come up on the screen, I would just be like, come on. No, we all make mistakes, but, you know, that's when I didn't have to put up with it. If it was a live deal and I did something like on a live feed thing, I'm sure there'd be plenty of people saying, what are you talking about? Very nice, very nice. Look at that. I mean, it's burning nice. Great draw. You know? Fantastic. Very fantastic. Very strong. It's like my tongue is coated. Very nice taste, though. Okay, well, there's a few of you that do some reviews that I know like a strong cigar. I know you'll like this. So I want to give it a try if you can find it. I think that's about it. I'm just trying to think if there's anything else that I'm forgetting. No, I don't think so. All sitting there like, just forgetting, you're not forgetting, be done. With that, I'm going to thank you very much for watching. I know it's a quickie compared to the other ones. Thank you very much for watching. I really appreciate it. I hope everybody's doing well. Try to stay out of danger, stay out of trouble, you know. We're all going to go sometime. Be nice if we could just all, you know, decide what day. Say, that day I'm going to go to sleep, and that's going to be it. I'm not going to wake up. But unfortunately, some of us check out via accidents, via disease, murder, suicide. I mean, there's all kinds of different ways that we all end up saying our goodbyes. So I just hope everybody's doing well. Hope your families are doing well, your loved ones, your children are safe. And for all of you that are making cigars and doing all that travel back and forth, and if you can, and you see this, if you happen to be one of the guys that making the cigars and stuff like that, and you happen to go into the factories, let them know that people say thank you for hand rolling a very nice cigar that smokes very nicely. You know, we wouldn't be smoking shit if they weren't doing that, you know? So hopefully somebody can thank them for us, you know? Or at least for me. Tell them Damon from Cigar Review TV said thank you. Okay? You can have them watch this video. You can, you know, write down the link. You can have them watch it on your phone. Okay. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. Hope you have a fantastic day, night, year, whatever it is. And find yourself a nice cigar, relax, talk to a friend, talk to yourself, and just enjoy your life a little bit for an hour or two. Take care, and thank you again for watching. I will be smoking with you pretty soon. Bye-bye.